Sometimes getting an impressive presentation is really hard. Well, it doesn't have to be so. In this video, you will be able to develop your PowerPoint presentation skills. Meet John. John hates public speaking. Yet, he has to defend his thesis impressively. With our help, John understood the three main processes for a flawless PowerPoint presentation. Now, he can confidently present his thesis. Kindly stay tuned to improve your PowerPoint presentation skills. Hello, intellects. If this is your first time, I am glad to have you here. You are highly welcome to Insights for You Today. If you want to keep getting great information on technologies that could help you achieve your academic goals quickly, please hit the subscribe button and the notification bell. For my returning viewers and subscribers, you guys rock my world. Thank you very much. Today, I will take you on a long ride on the three steps to developing your PowerPoint presentation skills. I will explain these steps in detail and with relevant examples. Suppose you watch every part of the video. In that case, I assure you that you will learn how to develop better content for your presentations, create awesome designs and deliver the best presentation for your assignments, research papers, thesis, or dissertations. Bear in mind that a good presentation has excellent content and beautiful designs and is delivered in the most creative way possible. So let us get to it now. Step 1. Develop your content. By developing your content, I mean what you intend to present to your audiences. You have to first prepare the content for your presentation. What is the best way to organize your content? First, analyze your audience. Who is your audience? As a student, definitely, your audiences are other students, your instructors, and examiners. You need to know your audience. What do they expect from you? What do they need from you? Understanding what your audience wants is a vital key to a successful presentation. Apart from specific things your audience may expect from you concerning your topic, research has shown that most presenters want to get to the point as early as possible. So when next you have a PowerPoint presentation to make, save your audience's time. Get to the point. Alright, still on preparing your content. You need to research and plan. Assuming you have a clear idea of what you want to accomplish in your presentation, begin brainstorming ideas. Make a list of the issues that you think are most significant. If you want to learn more, you should conduct some reading or research. As you would with any assignment, make notes. Don't worry how much information you've gathered at this early stage of your investigation. An advantage of having too much information is that you can then focus on the most crucial points rather than rushing into putting together the presentation, just to find out you are short on information. Then, create your outline. The SlideShare companies provided three steps in creating a good outline for your presentation. They taught that you must first determine the outline style, which could be chronological, narrative, topical, problem-solving, or the cause-and-effect style. I feel the nature of your topic and type of research should determine the kind of outline you should use. For example, if you're working on a study that has a timeline, the chronological outline may be better for you. Then group your raw data. It is all about organizing your data so that it is understood by your audience. Let us say we are carrying out a study on the topic, comparison of wildlife tourism in DR Congo in India. Take a paper or note and write down all your data gathered, connecting them to another line. Then, arrange your data into an outline format. Step 2. Create excellent designs. There are specific rules you must follow to create a great PowerPoint design. First, always use one concept per slide. Having only one point on each slide helps your audience quickly comprehend your message before returning their attention to you for further explanation. Also, make use of bullet points which should be very consistent. What about colors to use in your design? You should make use of high contrast colors like black and white. In addition to black and white, black and yellow are common high contrast pairings. Tahoma, Verdana, Impact Georgia, Lotto, ITC Souvenir, Arial, or any sans serif fonts for the font style are the best fonts to use. Finally is how to deliver your presentation. There are three things you must watch for an excellent presentation. There are your voice, body language, and movement. Sometimes, We get nervous, and it affects our voice. Do not worry. It is normal. The best way to conquer nervousness during presentations is to know and understand your topic very well. Also, plan ahead and practice and practice. However, if you have overcome fear during your presentation in the past, kindly let us know how you did it in the comment section below. We may learn one or two from your experience. Your voice must be natural and loud, but do not deafen your audience close to you. When you talk, display confidence and love for your topic. Make use of short sentences. It makes your audience understand you more. For body language, numerous studies have proven that standing straight and making good eye contact is the best body language during a presentation. You also need to be relaxed. Your body must communicate too, but avoid some lousy body language like folding your arms, wringing your hands, etc. Some men like to put their hands in their pockets. It is a no-no for your presentation. Try as much as you can to make lesser use of your hands during the presentation. Finally, your movement should be natural. It is good to move around during a presentation, but don't move around because you are nervous. You are going to stress your audience when you move around nervously. All right, intellect, I hope this video has been able to help you develop better content for your presentations, create awesome designs, and deliver the best presentation for your assignments, research papers, thesis, or dissertations. If yes, kindly hit the like button and share. See you in my next video. Thanks for watching. Bye.